Hello everybody, Duke here, and welcome to my first RuneScape quest guide. The quest we're going to take a look at today is the Waterfall quest, which is one of the first quest members usually do. It's a super easy quest, it shouldn't take you more than 40 minutes. If you're really quick and have teleports and potions, you can do it in 20. The required items are 6 air runes, 6 earth runes, 6 water runes and a rope. The items I recommend you bring is a Gems Necklace and a Ring of Dueling, and if you are low HP level, bring some high healing food. The Moss Giant's max hit is 14, so I really recommend you have 15 hit points. To start the quest, make your way south of the Barbarian Outpost. You can see the lines I've drawn on this little picture. You can use the Gems Necklace to teleport there, or the minigame teleport to Barbarian Assault, and you just walk straight south to the quest icon indicated on the map. When you've made your way to the quest start area, you talk to Almira. She's inside the house. You ask if she needs any help, and she says you have to go speak to her son. So you walk west, open the gate, and you take the raft. When you take the raft, you crash here. There is Hudson. You just you just speak to him. He tells you about a treasure. You ask if you can help him, and he's afraid you will steal the treasure, so he doesn't want any help. What you can do now, if you didn't bring a rope, is simply swim across the stream. You will take 8 damage. Make sure you have at least 9 HP. If you did bring a rope, instead of just swimming across the river, you can use your rope on the rock, then use your rope on the dead tree, and then just climb inside the barrel and you'll float safely down to the same spot. When you arrive at the shore, just walk northwest. You should go to this house and speak to Hadley. Go through all of the chat options with him, and then go upstairs. When you go upstairs, you should search the southern bookcase on the eastern wall. You will get a Book of Baxterian. You have to open this book if you want to progress with the quest, because if you don't open it, you won't be able to get the key you need later on. Now that you read the book, you should make your way down to the Tree Gnome Village entrance, the maze entrance. I've outlined 3 routes you could take here. You could walk normally just through East Ardoon and through the battlefield to get there, or you could use your Ring of Dueling to teleport to Castle Wars and walk up that route, or you could use your minigame teleport and go to the fishing trawler and walk the orange route. Here is a zoomed in map of the maze. You just follow the blue dotted line to get to the dungeon entrance. So here's just a fast forwarded version. You could also talk to Elkoi if you have been there before, and he will transport you to the end of the maze and you just walk backwards. Otherwise, if you are low level, be prepared to take some hits, so definitely have food with you. There's some hill giants at the very end there, otherwise it's not that scary. So you go down here and you will take the right route. Watch out for the hobgoblins, I believe their max hit is 4. You just search this crate here and you will get a key. You can then walk back. You can heal up outside of the dungeon if you need to, and this time go down and run left. Go inside here and talk to the gnome. He will give you Glareal's pebble, which you will need later on in the quest. So the note is that you will actually need Glareal's pebble later on in another quest called Roving Elves. And you can use the drop trick, so you drop the pebble and talk to the gnome again to get multiple of the item. Just so that's clear. Now go to a bank to deposit all your items except for the pebble and your food. You will not be able to bring your runes or armor with you. I recommend you either walk up to the East Ardoon bank, or you use your Games Necklace to teleport to Barbarian Assault, and I will show you where we're going after this. So if you went to the East Ardoon bank, you just follow the orange line up to the N at in Kingdom up there. If you use your Games Necklace, then you just follow the green line down, just like in the beginning. So this is the place you want to get to. What you do is you use the pebble on the gravestone and then you click on the gravestone, you will go down to this cave here, and I will show you in a moment why it's recommended you have at least 15 HP and high healing food. It doesn't really matter which way you go first, you get the amulet to the west here in the chest. By the way, if you can survive it, you should pick up several of the amulets by dropping it and searching it again, because you will actually lose one amulet to complete the quest. And you can also see my friend dying in the background. Then you run south, you can heal up in between if you want to, and you search the tomb to actually get the urn. Then you just head out of there. Now that you have the amulet and urn, go back to any bank. I recommend the Barbarian Assault teleport with the Games Necklace, because we are heading up there again. Bring your 6 water runes, earth runes, air runes, and a rope, and of course the amulet and urn. And head back to the place where we picked up the quest. Now that we're back where we picked up the quest, you just walk outside again, you click on the raft to get taken down to the buoy. You walk a little bit down, you use your rope on the rock. Remember, you have to use it on the rock because we're actually going down here. Use rope on the tree and go inside. You must have the Glareal's amulet on you to do this. You can't get inside without it. So what you do now is you run to the right from the entrance. I went the wrong way the first time. You search this crate right here to get a key. Watch out for the mages and skeletons and the spiders. You head to the west wing there, you go up, watch out for the fire giants. You use your key on the door, you pick up the next key and use it on that door. Now that you're in here, you use one of each rune on each of the pillars. So one water, one earth, one air on each of the pillars. When you've done that, you take off your Glareal's amulet if you have it on you, and you use it on the statue of Glareal. When you do that, the floor rises up, but do not click the trophy, because it will send you back downstream, so you'll have to run back up if you do that. What you're actually supposed to do is you use the urn on the chalice trophy thing. And that's it. Quest complete. You get some lovely rewards, as you can see on screen. And as I said, this is an easy quest. You could do this on a fresh account that just became a member. And you can also see we get to 29 attack and strength, essentially. Now that you're actually done with the quest, you can drop all the items if you want, but you will, as I said, you will need the pebble to do roaming elves, and you will need the Glareal amulet to actually get back into this cave if you want to kill fire giants or something similar. But you can definitely drop the keys and the book. This was my first quest guide video. I hope you enjoyed it. I would really appreciate it if you watched this far, you go down in the comment section and post something that could be better. Is there something I could have explained better? Is there something I missed? Was the travel options good enough? Because I mean, I did this as an Iron Man fresh account, I didn't have any teleports. So walking is definitely the my preferred method, but you could always teleport, and instead of using the teleportation jewelry, you could use Ardoon teleport, for example, or Janil, and stuff like that. So definitely leave me some feedback, I thrive on it, and I will create more guides. I do plan to create a guide for every single quest, and I do have everything recorded, it's just a little bit finicky to edit everything together. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed it, have a good one people, I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.